Yeah, well, the Victorian Ombudsman has been called in to investigate the state's bungled travel permit scheme, which has left dozens of residents stranded and unable to return home.
Vanna and Cameron Waters are from Phillip Island but have been stuck in Nambucca Heads in New South Wales. And Vanna and Cameron join us now. Good morning, guys. Nice to see you this morning. Appreciate your time. You haven't been home in 3.5 months.
Oh.
How tough has it been?
Oh, morning, Carl. Morning, Carl. Morning, Ali.
Morning.
We've actually been away for over 5 months, but we've been up in this area for 3.5. It's been hard. We miss our family. We miss our home. We just really want to get back there.
So we know you've applied for an exemption, but were rejected. Any idea why they knocked you back?
They don't give a reason. They've actually knocked pretty much everyone back that we've met. We get a generic printed out letter, no signature, no reason, and a referral to Lifeline and Beyond Blue, which is adding sort of insult to injury.
Tell me, that in my mind is an acknowledgement that they understand how incredibly difficult this situation is for people like yourselves.
Well, it certainly is an acknowledgement, and they know it's difficult, but there are so many of us up here, and I'm sure I speak for many, many of those people. We're all seniors, we're all retired. Probably most of us are double jabbed, and we're happy to isolate at home because we're retired. We're rule keepers, we're not rule breakers, so they really just need to test us at the border, let us go home, isolate for 14 days and then test us again.
Agree.
We're no risk to anybody.
Can I just say this? Ali described it diplomatically as an acknowledgement. I think it's a massive slap in the face. Could you have more disregard for your own residents?
Not really. It's a national disgrace. We were caught up in the start of COVID. We were stuck in Cairo, and it was easier for us to get home from Cairo to our home than it is for us to get from northern New South Wales to Victoria. It's a joke. And I know we have been in caravan campgrounds where every one of them has Victorians in this position. There are people who are in Queensland who have to make a 24-hour dash. They at least can get a transit permit to cross through New South Wales, but must do it in 24 hours. There are other people who are in Queensland that are going home via Northern Territory, down into South Australia, and then into Western Victoria to get back to their homes in Victoria. And these people are in their 60s, their 70s and their 80s. Mm. That is just totally ridiculous. We were 2 hours south of Queensland and we can't get a permit to go home.
And what's your view on the vaccines? I know on A Current Affair last night they featured a number of people over the age of 60 who are reticent to get AstraZeneca, and those stresses have been compounded by the way it's been handled. But how do you feel about that, and will that make a difference to you? Are you planning on getting a vaccine?
We're actually already double vaccinated and have been for some time. We have 6 kids, 10 grandkids. Most of our kids are now double vaccinated. Our grandkids are being vaccinated, who are in their early teens. It didn't kill us, it didn't hurt us. We're of the old school where you have a flu shot, or our children all had their childhood vaccinations. And that's just what you do. If you're a decent Australian, just get on board, have the shots, and let everyone return to normal. Because we are now being controlled by the government. We have no say in our lives. We're basically political prisoners up here.
Wow. Cameron, you live with an interesting woman.
My spokesperson.
Well, she says it so eloquently.
It's so good. Look, we think it's fantastic that you come on our show. If you're going to be anywhere Nambucca Heads, you can ride it out there. But just to be able to get home, the ability to get home, we're getting to the point now where it needs to stop. If people are double vaccinated, if people have done the right thing, they've isolated, they're getting antigen tests, whatever you need to do, tests, it's got to stop now. I mean, everyone's done everything right.
Yes.
Mm. Anyway, good on you guys. Thank you. Let us know how you go.
For sure.
Well, we do have the Victorian Ombudsman investigating now, so hopefully there will be a bit of movement because there are so many couples and families in the same situation. Mm.